Over the last 200 years, the soils in the United States have lost a lot of topsoil or organic matter and the carbon content within that organic matter. And indeed, increasing the organic matter in our soils is one of the best things that we can do to help offset the effects of drought and flooding. But it also helps increase the profitability and the productivity of our farms. However, learning how to manage the organic matter in our soils is one of the most important things that we can do before we even begin increasing the organic matter of our soils. I'm Rob from Dowdle Family Farms, and I'm a seventh generation farmer on land that was originally acquired from a land grant in 1826. Over the last 200 years, the farm has been used for pasture like it is now, but also for row crops like cotton. Over the last 5 years, I've been on this journey to increase the soil organic matter and the carbon content of the soil to increase the farm's profitability and its productivity. We currently raise grass-finished beef, pastured pork, and honeybees. You may have heard that we lose a lot of organic matter and topsoil through erosion and deep tillage. But before we can really begin understanding how we lose the organic matter content of our soil, we must first understand what that carbon cycle is like. When plants grow through photosynthesis, they take the carbon dioxide that's in the air, they take the carbons from that carbon dioxide, and it forms cell walls within the plant. Those physical structures that the plant makes contain carbon. So when that plant grows and has all these different carbons that form the stalks, the tree trunks, the leaves, whatever, it's consumed in a variety of different ways. It may lay down on the ground and be consumed by different bugs, bacteria, fungi, mushrooms, and return to the soil life. Some forms of that carbon, like in the form of leaves and grass, will decay very quickly, and part of that will return to the air, and a little bit of it will return to the soil. Other parts, like tree trunks that are high in lignin, that carbon may take several years to decay, and sometimes a larger portion of that carbon is remained in the soil, and it actually forms into more stable forms of carbon called humus. However, sometimes when animals or livestock eat that carbon in the form of grass or in the form of lettuce for people, part of it is exhaled in the form of carbon dioxide, and some of it may be returned to the soil. So carbon cycles, I hope you understand that this is a farmer's perspective on biology, and I'm not a biologist or a chemist by any stretch of the imagination, but I hope this offers a little bit of a descriptive way of recognizing this pattern. When we do tillage, what happens is it jumpstarts the soil life by increasing oxygen and oftentimes increasing the temperature of the soil. That carbon just goes into the atmosphere, and so the soil organic matter is then lost into the atmosphere rather than being maintained in the soil or through more plants. The other thing that often contributes to the loss of organic matter in the soils, as best I understand it, is the addition of nitrogen fertilizers beyond what the soil requires. Those nitrogen fertilizers jumpstart soil life that help break down the carbon, and from there that excess carbon is then released into the atmosphere. And what happens is we lose that carbon content in the soil quicker than we can replenish it. The thing that's important to remember in that carbon cycle, though, is as plants grow, they use carbon. So we need to make sure we replenish that carbon through growing more plants, and that it's not oxidized into the atmosphere at a faster rate than we can replenish it into the soil. There are two things that are important for us to remember. First, we want to make sure that we don't lose carbon or organic matter in our soils when we don't need to, through things like excess nitrogen use, erosion, or any other kind of form. The second thing that we want to do, though, is make sure that we replenish the carbon materials in our soils, the organic matter of our soils, at a faster rate than it is used. Now, if you want to learn how to increase the carbon content of our soils, check out our next video. When it's published, I'll publish it right here so that you can watch it then. Until next time, take care, have a great day, and we'll see you soon.